been having some great discussions lately about goal scoring and release techniques and tactics. Been doing some work on it over the last few months here. I'm just going to share some of the findings. Take it how you like it. Again, I never preach it. I'm the be-all, end-all and know all of this. I just observe and state my observations and try to stay neutral as much as possible. So this is kind of the goals. This is about 260 or 280 goals that were scored in the NHL. This is the total, I guess. I did them in day by day, so I've got a chart for each day, but this is the kind of the grand total. So what you'll see, what stands out is clean shots with full control and clean shot off of passes make up just about half of all goals scored. The other half is a dog's breakfast of all kinds of different things there. There's, you can read through those. They kind of make up the bulk of what goals are scored. There's one or two that don't fit into any of these categories, but these categories pretty much cover most of the goals. Some of them, so it takes a bit of a decision making to try to put them into, figure out the right category for them, but this generally works pretty good. It covers most of it. So from there, what I did was take all of the clean shots with full control and put those into a separate category. So when they got into their own category, then I started watching where those goals were coming from, what foot they were coming off of, and what kind of shot. So these two, the outside foot and the inside foot, those are wrist shots or snapshots. There's really no wind up to those. It's a controlled shot. Slap shot outside foot, of course, that's a regular slap shot. 2 foot, that's goals that were scored where the player was gliding on 2 feet and shot, didn't lift any foot or really transfer. The weight came off of both feet. It was more of an upper body thrust and lever type shot and backhand shots. So, that's kind of what it sorted out to. I just got a compilation of a bunch of things that are inside foot plays, whether it's passes, shots, or whatever. So just to kind of create a visual around where plays off of the inside foot are being used and what they look like. So I'm just going to hop in and start running through some of those videos. So this one, pass across the blue line, inside foot shot. So everything should have a slow motion to it. So there, that player catches, steps onto the inside foot, and releases chest and eyes at the net. Here's a pass off of the inside foot, so you can see the hands are away from the body. It's a thrust pass using the core and the arm strength more than a lateral weight transfer. One of my favorite plays of all time, the Erik Karlsson pass in playoffs last year. So just goes down, fakes that inside shot, but as soon as that top hand comes away from the body and the body rotates, so you can see that the feet are still continuing this way, but the crest of his jersey is pointed this way. Top hand has come right away from the body, and the blade completely opens up for that pass across the seam. So another really good inside foot play. Everybody thinks shot. That's the deceptive tactics of being able to go off the inside foot. Here's a good breakdown of the shot. Oh, I guess it's a pass, but kind of what the motion looks like. So Backstrom steps from his outside foot to his inside foot, and you can see the top hand already coming away from the body, and then that top hand kind of reaches its apex all the way out. The weight that is transferred now goes down into the bottom hand. You can see the bottom hand is starting to flex the stick, and then the stick just works like a lever while the body bends kind of at the waist to create that power. Here's a pass off of the inside foot, and again, always that top hand. That's one of the most deceptive plays that you can do when you're making plays off of the inside foot, especially passes, is teach players to get that top hand away from the body. Again, puck behind the heel, top hand away, rotating from separating lower body from upper body. Same thing again, another pass, inside foot. Everybody just freezes right here. Goalie and defenseman, you can see, are thinking shot, and then just the ability to push that top hand away from the body and push a puck across a seam. Morgan Riley does this great. He's one of the best guys I've seen at doing it, just again dropping that puck behind the heels and transferring that weight towards the net. Here's Van Riemsdyk, almost the same as what Riley is doing, except across the hash marks rather than the blue line. Austin Matthews, soft catch shot. This is a good example of the weight transfer that comes in a soft catch shot. So there, he starts with his stick on his inside foot. So that stick is, or I guess here it would be outside foot. Sorry for the confusion there. This is his outside foot because as a left-handed player, the inside foot is always the foot that's closest to your stick. So he starts his stick at the outside foot, transfers it to the inside foot, and that's where that power comes from for the release. Another one, inside foot, just a nice deceptive shot. The release kind of, it actually looks funny, but just the way it comes off, it's really nice. Jamie Benn's great at the inside foot shot. Picks it up, drops it. Just about gets stick lifted, but gets it off anyway. It's a beautiful goal. Really quick release. Steps onto it, transfers that weight, hands away from the body. Puck's gone. Nice deceptive little step there. One stride onto the inside foot, hands away, levers the shot, and it's in. Another one, skating cross crease. Just a clean inside foot shot there. Picks it up, makes a stick handle with it, steps onto the inside foot, and release. Lean away shot. That one gets chipped in, but the shot is kind of what we're concentrated on. Comes down, steps to the inside foot, and releases. Austin Matthews again, his shot. I've done a few other videos on what he's doing, but his shot is pretty amazing. See a few of the other Leafs guys are doing it. Which could have something to do with Daryl Belfry. I think that's where kind of these techniques really originated from, and he's the first guy to actually break them down and make people aware of them and bring kind of some understanding to it. I think he's still with the Leafs. I know he was with the Leafs, but I see a lot of the Leafs guys shooting the way he talks about, and there's goals coming from it. Marchand is great at this too. He's got numerous goals. I've probably got about 5 or 6 of his goals, inside foot goals. Either in movement, he can shoot in stride like that, or stationary there, you can see too. Even Derek Dorsett scoring like that. It's a nice one, Florida. Yeah, and just numerous examples of being able to use that inside foot and why we'd want to teach it and introduce players to it. Again, you'd never want to go away from the outside foot shot. I always say it's, you know, as many shots as a player can have, the better they're going to be, being able to just decide when that they need it and be comfortable with shooting off of both feet, off of backhand or forehand, 360 degrees around your body. Any way that you can release that puck, I've got videos of guys flying through the air, batting it in, guys sliding on both knees, guys sliding on one knee. Just being able to practice all of those things and get young players familiar with being able to score all of these goals. Again, back to just to finish off with the pie chart, right? You know, here's the goals that are being scored. So if we're out on the ice as coaches and saying only shoot off of your outside foot and not practice any of these other things, we're probably missing the boat and having very narrow mind to it. So I know I've changed the way I coach and teach shooting quite a bit based on this research and some of the things I've been picking up. So just trying to bring some awareness to it. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave something in the comments. Thanks.